So for the patient with dementia, the importance of the communication if someone does have to go into hospital and if someone is returned from hospital is perhaps even more important than for someone who is returning to an active, independent life. So knowledge for the hospital, or for that patient entering hospital, their background history, the things that we already know might make their dementia worse. So, for instance, their likelihood of getting urinary tract infections, of being constipated when they're immobile, so they go in with a leg injury or something else. If I've got information in my notes about what has previously caused a deterioration in their function, that is absolutely vital for their hospital stay. So roll on a PCEHR or a way of getting that information to the hospital in a timely fashion, and equally importantly, getting it out of the hospital in a timely fashion so that I know what their medications are. It might be that they live alone and they have a Webster pack. Well, we need to get that Webster pack packed immediately on their return from hospital with the new medications. Otherwise, there will be a lag of a week or 2 weeks before the change in medication actually comes through.
It can be very important to have family members at the bedside for a patient who's developing delirium. First of all, they may point out to the staff that it's developing and that the patient's behaviour is abnormal for them. They can also give us information as to what the patient's like normally and what illnesses they may have which can precipitate it. And of course also they can be very reassuring for the patient.
So sometimes we would send people home who still have a delirium, but ensuring that we're sending them home with family members or carers who are able to follow that up, making sure that someone else follows them up to ensure that they are recovering. Certainly hospital isn't a great place for a confused older person to be. Sometimes they have to be here to get the appropriate care, but if we can avoid that, that's best case scenario.
We're not good at transferring information to the GP, and with a delirium it is absolutely essential that the GP is aware that their patient has suffered from a delirium, because it may indicate an underlying dementia, it may indicate a general deterioration in their mental state. So it's important at discharge that the word delirium is included in the discharge summary.
The patient with dementia who's discharged from hospital, I really value a phone call, and very often I get it from the resident medical officer who's on the ward, letting me know that they have been discharged, and that's because they are more vulnerable than your average patient. So I'm going to need to see them or be aware of what their change in medication is, what their change in function is, and be really aware of what sort of follow-up requirements they might need.
So if someone still has some delirium, we do, for any patient that leaves the hospital, we will do follow-up phone calls to ensure that they're recovering. We would also ask that their GP follow them up to make sure that they are recovering. And just make sure that the family know that if this doesn't improve, they need to come back.
With someone with delirium without a history of dementia, we suggest they come back to a memory clinic to be assessed approximately 3 months later. That gives time for any underlying delirium to have resolved.